Hi everyone, welcome back to another video from Wesknows Tech News and Reviews. Today we'll be doing a heart rate accuracy test during a skipping workout with the Huawei Band 6 as well as the Redmi Smart Band Pro. So without further ado, let's get into it. Right, so at my local gym I went for 500 skips. During that exercise I was measuring the count of skips on both of these watches as well as a smart jump rope which has rotatable handles. So every time you rotate to take a skip it counts it as one. So we've got that as the benchmark for the count of skips. And then of course we have the heart rate accuracy test. So the benchmark there is a Polar H10 ECG chest strap which is on my chest all during the workout. So that is the most accurate measure of the heart rate. That will be the benchmark and we'll see what the optical heart rate sensors on the back of these two smart bands actually have to show for themselves. Now we know that Xiaomi and Redmi have been doing quite a few firmware updates. Previously I've done a high intensity workout and the results on the Redmi Pro were pretty good. Let's see how it stands up 6 months later against the infamous Huawei Band 6. But before we get into the actual review, let me tell you slightly about these two watches. So we bring things into concept. How do they actually differ from themselves? Well, first of all, both smart bands, you can see them right here, they are very similar in design. Now, both of them have integrated straps, so integrated into the watch case. They're not sitting on any kind of lugs. Now they both have a plastic design to them, which is great, I suppose, but the biggest difference in design is in regards to Huawei Band 6 actually getting a button on the side. The Redmi Smart Band Pro is just the traditional fitness tracker. There is no physical buttons anywhere. Well, there's not even a capacitive button as you would expect because it's brim to brim, just AMOLED display. So you get 194 by 368 pixels, popping out 282 PPI. Both of these trackers actually give you a brightness of up to 450 nits. Considering these are budget trackers, this is pretty darn bright. Both of these display sizes are actually 1.47 inches. That is also quite a huge display. Now this is comparable to the smartwatches out there which cost a ton more money. Considering that these are just budget fitness trackers, you don't get any onboard space to download music to. You also don't get inbuilt GPS, but what you do get are 110 sport modes on the Redmi Pro Smart Band Pro and you get 100 sport modes on the Huawei Band 6. Now the Huawei Band 6 is famous for quite a few things. Well, first of all, it was one of the first trackers that to come out with a physical button on the side to have as many sport modes as the Huawei GT2 smartwatch, so that's 100 sport modes. And then of course it was the first fitness tracker available to bring you continuous SpO2 measurement. So SpO2 is your blood oxygen saturation. Now the Redmi Smart Band Pro came out about four or five months after Huawei Band 6, but it also came about with a very similar display, basically same specs, 282 PPI, 1.47 inch display, also 450 nits of brightness, so that's all very similar. And it also provided you with continuous SpO2 measurement. Now both of these watches can monitor your sleep and they monitor your going to sleep time, your awake time, and in between your light, your deep and REM sleep. They've got your stress monitoring on here and it's also continuous heart rate monitoring. So pretty much similar specs. So now that we've talked about the watches, let's get into the accuracy test of the skip count as well as heart rate accuracy. So you will see that there is quite a bit of heart rate variability. So there are these sharp peaks, sharp troughs, and so forth. But once again, the benchmark was the Polar H10 ECG chest strap. So let's look at the results from that chest strap. And then we'll look at the Huawei results and then the Redmi Smart Band Pro. Let's do it. So we can see that the chest strap actually came up with the average heart rate at 143 beats per minute, while the max was 160 beats per minute. So an average of 143 and a max of 160. Let's take a look at the results from the Huawei Band 6. And we can see an average of 132 beats per minute, while the max was 148 beats per minute. So what does this mean? Well, it means that the Huawei Band 6 actually showed us the average mark to be 8% lower, or understating the average from the Polar H10 ECG chest strap. On top of that, we can see that the max has an understatement of 12 beats per minute. So that's another approximately 8%. So these results are obviously not ideal. They're not awful, but they are what they are. An understatement of 8% for the average and an understatement of 8% for the max. Now let's take a look at what the Redmi Smart Band Pro shows us. Hopefully the results will be better. Let's take a look. And now for the results on the Redmi Smart Band Pro, we see an average at 140 beats per minute, while the max has actually reached 171 beats per minute. Okay, so we have an understatement of the average by 3 beats per minute. That's about just over 2%. While the overstatement on the max is 11 beats per minute. And once again, that's around 8%. All right, so we can see that Huawei has shown a consistent understatement of 8% on both the average and the max. Now, the Redmi Smart Band Pro did show itself better on the average, just a 2% understatement, while the max overstated by 8%. Now, I would say that the fitness trackers, they are very budget, so I don't expect them to show this amazingly great result. But still being within the 10% mark of the chest strap, I think that's an okay result. But if they were within the 5% mark, that would be amazing. Anyways, now let's get onto the skip count accuracy. So first we'll take a look at what the jump rope has shown us, and it's actually 503 jumps. So this is the real benchmark. This is the number of jumps I've done on the skipping rope in just under 10 minutes. Now the Huawei Band 6 gives us 449 jumps. Well, we're still out by just over 10%. While if we take a look at the results from the Redmi Smart Band Pro, wow, it's just 303 jumps, giving us an understatement by 200 jumps. That is huge. This is the worst result we've seen to date. Let's be frank. That's an understatement by 40%. So if you were there jumping and you think, why am I jumping? I should have like 1,000 jumps, but really it's just showing you 600. That's probably not the best case. So it's not very accurate in that regard. But hey, let's sum it up. So if we talk about heart rate accuracy, Huawei Band 6, well, an understatement by 8% for the average, understatement by 8% on the max. Redmi Smart Band Pro acted better. Just a 2% understatement on the average, an 8% overstatement on the max, which is a bit of a worry, but hey, it was closer on the average. In regards to the skip count, the Redmi Smart Band Pro is just, wow, that result is really bad. Having an understatement of 40%, that is a huge variance. Now the Huawei Band 6 didn't do too badly. An understatement by 10%, well, I think it's okay. It's not super great, but it's not awful, considering that the Garmin Venu 2 gave us an understatement of about 7.5%. So 10% in perspective is not too bad. Anyways, thank you for watching this accuracy test. If you did enjoy it, please drop me a like. If you want to see more of the same, you know what to do. Please hit the red subscribe button below the video, and I'll see you in the next one.